As a quick refresher, we've been working with example survey data that has missing values. One way to deal with these missing values is just to eliminate any observations that have missing data. But because of the negatives related to that, we might want to keep all the observations and just try to fill in the blanks, so to speak. The important thing here is to provide the fake data so that our model can get closer to what's actually true. One common method is to replace the missing values with a predefined statistic, the mean, median, or mode. As a reminder to all of us, the mean is the average of the values. Technically, it's where we add up all the existing values and divide them by the number of values you have. The median is the midpoint of the data values. To determine this, you basically put all the values in order and then select the value that's halfway between the first and the last values. The mode is the most common of the data values. In other words, it's the value that occurs most often in the data set. If you remember in one of our previous segments, we showed what the real ages were for respondents number 3 and number 9. I've gone ahead and added in the rest of the real data for the purpose of our example. If you recall in that segment, the average or mean age for the known respondents was 40. If we impute 40 for all the missing age values and impute the average income for each of the missing income values, which in this case is 60,000, we can then see the effect that it has in comparison to using the delete method for dealing with the missing data. Here we see a scatter plot of the real data. The slope of the line would indicate in general that as age increases, so does income. But if we look at the scatter plot where we just delete records that have missing data, we can see that this scatter plot of the leftover data actually has the slope of the line going in the wrong direction, indicating that as age increases, income goes down. And when we add in a scatter plot of the imputed data using the averages of the existing data, we find that though it may not be quite accurate, it at least gets us going in the right direction as to the slope of the line. The imputed data model isn't perfect, but it does seem to get us closer in this specific case. Let's put what we've learned together in the form of a quiz.